Hello students, how are you all? In last class you learned proteins. The today's topic is nucleic acids. The particles present in the nucleus of cell responsible for the heredity are called as chromosomes. And the chromosomes are made up of proteins and nucleic acids. First, write the statement. The particles present in the nucleus of cell responsible for heredity are called chromosomes And the chromosomes are made up of proteins and nucleic acids. And our topic is nucleic acids. There are mainly two types of nucleic acids. They are, the first one is DNA and the second one is RNA. The first one is deoxyribonucleic acid. Nothing but we have to call it as a DNA. And the second one is a
nucleic acids are mainly two types. They are mainly two types. One is deoxyribonucleic acid, one is ribonucleic acid. And nucleic acids are the long chain polymers of nucleotides. Polynucleotides. So nucleic acids are the long chain polymers of nucleotides, also called as a polynucleotides. So this is introduction regarding the nucleic acids.
Next, chemical composition of nucleic acids. Complete hydrolysis of nucleic acids, nothing but DNA or RNA, yields pentose sugar, phosphoric acid and nitrogen containing heterocyclic compound, nothing but bases. Nucleic acids, nothing but DNA or RNA. So DNA or RNA upon hydrolysis. Complete hydrolysis. One product is a pentose sugar. And another product is phosphoric acid. And another product is a nitrogen containing heterocyclic compound. Nitrogen containing heterocyclic compound. Nothing but bases. So this is the upon complete hydrolysis of nucleic acids, they'll give one product is pentose sugar, one product is phosphoric acid, and another product is a nitrogen containing heterocyclic compound, nothing but bases. Now we'll discuss one by one detail. First, what is the pentose sugar present in the nucleic acids? Next, phosphoric acid, then nitrogen containing heterocyclic compounds. First, we'll discuss what is the pentose sugar? What is the pentose sugar present in the nucleic acids? First, I'm taking pentose sugar. This is the first one. So what is the pentose sugar present in the nucleic acid? The pentose sugar present in the nucleic acid is nothing but ribose. That is right, the structure. CHO, there are 5 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is the 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At first carbon, there is the aldehyde function group. At last carbon, we have to take CH2OH. So this is the first carbon, this is the third carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, this is the fifth carbon. So first carbon aldehyde function group, at last carbon CH2OH. At remaining carbons, we have take OH is on right side. So OH is on right side. So at second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, OH group present at right side. At second remaining valencies of these carbons can be satisfied by using hydrogen. So this is a D ribose. So the pentose sugar present in the nucleic acids, DNA and RNA, is a D ribose. Then we have take a cyclic form. So here the aldehyde function group for convenience purpose I'm writing as a C double bond OH. And it is found that the OH group present at the fourth carbon. This OH group present at the fourth carbon will involve the ring formation. So this bond is moving to here. So oxygen will get a negative charge. This hydrogen at fourth carbon OH group is there. This hydrogen is transferring to here. This O minus will become OH. Then I'm writing this is the first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, this is the fifth carbon. So fifth carbon CH2OH, this remains same. At first carbon, this bond is moving to here, this O will be negative charge. This negative one, this will take this hydrogen from at the fourth carbon OH group, this will become OH. This will become OH, this hydrogen I am writing right side, OH. Then remaining part you have to write as usual. So second carbon OH, right side, third carbon OH, right side. This valence is satisfied by hydrogen, this valence is satisfied by hydrogen, here also with hydrogen. So this first carbon and fourth carbon. This is the first, second, third, fourth, and this is the fifth carbon. So there is a ring formed between fourth carbon and first carbon through oxygen. So this ring contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is a 5-membered ring. So this structure is nothing but OH group is present at left hand side. At first carbon OH group present at left hand side. OH group present at left hand side we have to call it as a beta. So if the OH group present at right side here, the OH group present here we have to call it as alpha. OH is at right side at first carbon, alpha form. OH group at left side at first carbon we have to take as beta form. Beta, and this is a D ribose. Beta D ribose. The sugar is a beta D ribose present in the nucleic acids. And one more difference is in the case of sugar moiety, DNA as well as RNA cases. First, I'm taking this is a cyclic form, Haworth structure. For this case, we have to write Haworth structure. So, how would write the Haworth structure? This oxygen I'm taking, and how many carbons? 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? So this is the first carbon, this is the second carbon, this is third carbon, this is the fourth carbon. Right, at first carbon, what are the groups present right side we have to take at the bottom, already learned in the carbohydrate chapter. And what are the groups present at left side we have to take on the top. So this is the hydrogen OH, this OH present at the right side, nothing but inside the ring, we have to take at the bottom. So at this carbon, first carbon, OH is at the top side, we have to take hydrogen at the bottom. Right. At the second carbon, OHH. So OH at the down, H at the top side, upside. At third carbon, OH present at right side. Right side in the sense we have to take at the bottom. This is we have to take at upside. Then remaining at fourth carbon, it is involved in the ring, this one, this oxygen. Next, CH2OH. So CH2OH always we have to take at top side, CH2OH hydrogen at the bottom. So this is the fifth carbon. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is the Haworth structure of this D ribose, beta D ribose. For this Haworth structure of beta D ribose, we have to apply to the have to take for the DNA molecule as well as RNA molecule. There is a light difference is there. First, I'm taking DNA. So what is how the ribose sugar is present in a DNA? So same structure I'm writing. Right, this is the first carbon, this is second carbon, this is third carbon, this is the fourth carbon. At first carbon, OH group as usual you have right, hydrogen as usual you have right. At second carbon, hydrogen is there. So this oxygen we have to remove. Only hydrogen we have to take for the case of DNA. At remaining places we have to take as usual. This is CH2OH, this is H. If you look at this structure, this is a beta D ribose. This is nothing but beta D ribose. But these two are same, but at second position we removed this OH, only we placed the hydrogen. So at this place. So here is no oxygen is present. So that we have to call as at second position no oxygen. So it is a beta D 2-deoxyribose. Beta D 2-deoxyribose. So beta D 2-deoxyribose sugar. Simply deoxyribose. So DNA contains a 2-deoxyribose sugar. Simply deoxyribose sugar. In the case of RNA, if you take the RNA as usual. So at first carbon OH, H, this is a hydrogen, this is a OH, hydrogen, OH, CH2OH, and this is the H. This is a ribose, beta D ribose sugar. So what is the difference you identified in the case of DNA as well as RNA? In the case of DNA, at second position there is no oxygen in the case of sugar, but in the case of RNA there is a oxygen is present, OH group present at second position, oxygen present at the second position. So that it is a beta D 2-deoxyribose, this is a beta D ribose. So these are the small difference between the DNA and RNA. So this is deoxyribose, this contains a oxygen at the second position. So DNA is a deoxyribose sugar. So this is the sugar present in the DNA and RNA molecule. First one is a complete hydrolysis of nucleic acid, you get pentose sugar. The pentose sugar we are discussing, the pentose sugar is nothing but D-ribose. DNA contains beta D 2-deoxyribose and RNA contains beta D ribose sugar. So this is a first one, pentose sugar.
Next, nitrogen containing nucleocyclic compounds nothing but bases. Nucleic acid contains two types of bases. They are the first one is purines, the second one is pyrimidines. Nucleic acids contains two types of bases. They are first one is purines and the second one is pyrimidines. Purines and pyrimidines. First we discuss about purines. First one is purines. The basic structure of purines we can take as here is one hydrogen, here is another nitrogen. So this is the basic structure of our purines. Here is one hydrogen is present, here is one dipole, here is another dipole. So this is the basic structure of our purines. And purines are two types. One is adenine and the second is guanine. First we try the adenine structure. Same structure we have taken. So here is nitrogen, here is another nitrogen. Nitrogen double bond. Here is NH2. NH2 present here. There is one by one, here is by one, here is another by one. So this is a NH2. This is NH2 divided by letter. This is NH2 divided by letter. Next one is guanine. Same basic structure you can take, same structure we have taken. So nitrogen, here also will be another nitrogen. And here is double bond O, here is NH2. NH2, double bond is that, here this is NH. Here also H is present. Then this is a guanine. This is guanine denoted by letter. So purine cycle type. So this is the basic structure of purine. Purine cycle type. So one is adenine denoted by letter capital A, and second is guanine. This denoted by capital letter C. And these are the structures of adenine as well as guanine. This is the basic structure of purine. So purine cycle type adenine and guanine. The second one is a pyrimidines. There are three types of pyrimidines present in the nucleic acids. Pyrimidines are three types. They are cytosine, thymine, and uracil. The basic structure of pyrimidine is this one: nitrogen, double bond, pi bond, here is another pair. So this is the basic structure of pyrimidine. We take this basic structure. We have to write the structures of cytosine, thymine, and uracil. First, I am writing the structure of cytosine. Nitrogen, here is another nitrogen. Here is a pi bond, here is this pi bond. Here is another pi bond. This carbon plus there is a double bond. And here is a double bond. So this is a cytosine. Cytosine written by C. Next, thymine. Thymine. This is a pi bond. Here is a double bond. This will become NH. This also here is a NH. And here is a double bond. This also will become NH. Here is a methane. This is thymine. This is the structure of thymine. The next one is a uracil. N, this is NH, this also will be NH. Here is a pi bond, here is double bond low, here also double bond low. So this is uracil. Uracil driven by. So these are the pyrimidines present in the nucleic acids. Purines are two types, one is adenine, the second one is guanine. Pyrimidines are three types, they are the cytosine. Pyrimidine basis three types, cytosine, thymine, and uracil. In DNA, the purines are the adenine and the guanine. So DNA contains adenine and guanine. Purines are the adenine and guanine. Adenine and guanine both are present in the DNA. Pyrimidines. Pyrimidines present in the DNA, cytosine and thymine. But DNA do not contain uracil. So the pyrimidine, that uracil is not present in the DNA. DNA do not contain uracil. DNA do not contain uracil. This is important point. Next, in RNA, purines, what are the purines present? Purines both are adenine and guanine. Both are present. Adenine and guanine. Edelin and guanine present in the RNA. Purines. Pyrimidines. So what are the pyrimidines present in the RNA? So RNA contains uracil. One pyrimidine is uracil and another pyrimidine is cytosine. They contain cytosine and uracil. And RNA do not contain thymine. RNA do not contain thymine. RNA do not contain thymine. So these are the nitrogen bases present in the nucleic acids. Nitrogen bases are two types. One is purines, the second one is pyrimidines. So purines are there are two types. So one is adenine, guanine. So pyrimidines are like three types: so cytosine, thymine, and uracil. This is the basic structure for pyrimidine, and this is the basic structure for purines. Next, in DNA, purines are adenine and guanine. Pyrimidines are cytosine and thymine. But DNA do not contain uracil. Next, next in RNA, purines are adenine and guanine. Pyrimidines are cytosine and uracil, and RNA do not contain thymine. So this is the nucleic acids present in nitrogen-containing heterozygous compounds, nitrogen-containing heterozygous compounds in different bases in the nucleic acids. Next one is phosphoric acid. Third one we have is phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid. This phosphoric acid is nothing but H3PO4. H3PO4 is present in the nucleic acid. In the form of, you can take phosphate PO4-3. So this is a phosphate. So the another compound present in the upper hydroxylating the three compounds. First one is a pentose sugar, nothing but ribose. The second one is a nitrogen containing hydroxylation, nothing but base. So the third one is phosphoric acid. So these are the species present in the nucleic acids. Chemically they composed of pentose sugar, nitrogen containing heterocyclic compound, nothing but bases, and the phosphoric acid.
Next, structure of nucleic acids. In that, first one is a nucleoside. A unit formed by the attachment of a base to the first carbon, one dash position of sugar, is known as a nucleoside. That is the statement. A unit formed by attachment of base. Attachment base to first position, nothing but one dash position of sugar. Position of sugar is known as nucleoside. Is known as a nucleoside. The nucleoside is equal to sugar plus base. So this is the composition of a nucleoside. Nucleoside contains a sugar and a base. The base, a unit formed with attachment of a base to the one dash position, first position of a sugar, is known as a nucleoside. Let us write the structure of nucleoside. In the case of structure of nucleoside, first we have to write of pentose sugar, avart structure, ribose sugar. This is right. This is the first position, and this is second carbon. This is the third carbon. This is the fourth carbon, and here is base is present. We are attaching at first carbon. Here is hydrogen. So this is H. This is OH. Here is a H. This is OH. Here is a CH2OH. Here we can take a H. This is the sugar. Now the point is, this base also we have to give numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, and so it is a ring. We have to give numbering to it. So to differentiate the numbering of base and sugar, we are labeling the sugar numbering as this is 1-, this is the 2-, this is 3-, this is the 4-, and this is a 5-. So 1-, 2-, 3-, 4-, and 5-. So to the sugar base is attached at first position, 1' position. So this is a nucleoside. Nucleoside is nothing but a unit formula attachment of base to first position, 1' position of sugar is known as a nucleoside. This is the structure of nucleoside. Structure of nucleoside. Next, the second one is nucleotide. This is the first one. The second one is nucleotide. Nucleotide. So when nucleoside, this one, when nucleoside is linked to the phosphoric acid at a 5' position of sugar moiety, then you'll get a nucleotide. When nucleoside linked to phosphoric acid, when nucleoside linked to phosphoric acid at a 5' position of sugar moiety, we get a nucleotide. We'll get a nucleotide. So nucleotide is equal to sugar plus, that means nucleoside made up of sugar plus base. That means nucleotide is equal to nucleoside plus phosphoric acid. Nothing but sugar plus base plus phosphoric acid. So this is a nucleotide. Let us write the structure of a nucleotide. I'm taking a pentose sugar, Haworth structure. This is the Haworth structure of pentose sugar. This is the first position, second position, third position. This is the fourth position. 1', this is the 2', this is the 3', this is the 4', and you get here is a CH2 5'. So this is a base, and here is hydrogen H, this is OH, this is H. So at 5' position, at this position we have to attach a phosphoric acid. We will get a O, P double bond O, O minus. So this is a base sugar and a phosphoric acid. Base sugar, phosphoric acid, we have to call it as a nucleotide. This is the structure of nucleotide. So first one is the structure of nucleic acid. The first one is nucleoside and the second one is a nucleotide. Nucleoside nothing but sugar plus base. So and base attached to the sugar moiety at first position, 1' position. In the case of nucleotide, the nucleoside when linked to the phosphoric acid at the 5' position of sugar moiety, we get a nucleotide. So this is a sugar plus base plus phosphoric acid. This is nucleotide and nucleotide. Next, nucleotides are joined together by a phosphodiester linkage between 5' and 3' carbon atoms of pentose sugar. First, write the statement. Nucleotides are joined together. Joined together by phosphodiester. Together by phosphodiester linkage between 5' and 3' carbon atoms of pentose sugar. Now let us look at the formation of a dinucleotide. So for this case, first I'm taking one nucleotide first. So this is, first I'm writing pentose sugar. Pentose sugar, here is the base is present. So this is a base. and here is H, this is the OH I am taking. Here is CH2O, P double bond O, O minus, O minus. So this is the 1 dash, this is the 2 dash, this is the 3 dash, this is the 4 dash, and this is the 5 dash. This is a one nucleotide. This is one nucleotide plus. I am taking another nucleotide, same. And here is again base, this is a base HOH, this is a CH2O, P double bond O, O minus, O minus. This is a 5 dash, this is the 1 dash, this is the 2 dash, 2 dash, this is 3 dash, this is the 4 dash, and this is 5 dash. This is another nucleotide. So I took here is two nucleotides. This is one nucleotide and this is a second nucleotide. So these nucleotides are joined together by phosphodiester linkage. Then what the structure going to get is here is base as usual. This is base. This is a 1 dash, this is a 2 dash, this is a 3 dash, 4 dash. Here as usual I am writing CH2O, O minus, O minus, negative charge. Next, this is the OH group is here. So between these two forming a phosphodiester linkage. Double bond O, O minus. O, CH2, so this is 1 dash, this is the 2 dash, this is 3 dash, 4 dash, and this is the 5 dash. So this is a 3 dash end and this is a 5 dash end of chain. This is the 5 dash end of chain, this is the 3 dash end of chain. So this is a dinucleotide. What is the product we got is a dinucleotide. The product we got a dinucleotide. This is one nucleotide and this is another nucleotide. These two nucleotides are joined together by a phosphodiester linkage. So we got a dinucleotide. The dinucleotide joined with another nucleotide, you get trinucleotide. Like that you will get tetranucleotide, pentanucleotide, you will get polynucleotide. The polynucleotide is nothing but nucleic acid chain. So we are going to get a polynucleotide. So here one nucleotide, this is another nucleotide. Two nucleotide joined, we got a dinucleotide. The dinucleotide joined with another nucleotide, you get a trinucleotide. Trinucleotide join with another nucleotide, you get tetranucleotide, and so on. We'll get many number of nucleotides present in a chain. We have to call it as a polynucleotide. Then the polynucleotide chains can be represented as I'm taking first sugar. First I'm taking a sugar. To this sugar base is attached. Base. So to the sugar base attached, and this attached to phosphate. Phosphate. So this is one nucleotide. This nucleotide joined to another nucleotide. Again I am taking a sugar. To this sugar base. Next we have to write phosphate. Phosphate. This is another nucleotide. Then to this continuation sugar. Then we have to write here is base. Then we have to write a phosphate. We have to write a phosphate and so on. So this structure is repeating. So I'm taking as a taken N. This taken represent many number of sugar base phosphate moieties are repeating. That means this nucleotide is repeating. We have to call it as a polynucleotide. This is a simpler representation of chain of nucleic acid chain. This is nucleic acid, nothing but polynucleotide. So this is the structure of nucleic acid. So one nucleic acid, one nucleotide joined to another nucleotide, you will get dinucleotide, and dinucleotide react with linkage with another nucleotide will come trinucleotide, and so on. You'll get many number of nucleotides are joined. You'll get polynucleotide. Nothing but this is a nucleic acid chain, contains many number of nucleotides. Next, structure of DNA. The double strand helix structure for DNA was given by James Watson and Francis Crick. Watson and Crick. The double strand helix structure for DNA was given by Watson and Crick. James Watson and Francis Crick. Next, if you look at the structure of DNA, here is this, there are two strands. This is a 5 dash end of chain, this is a 3 dash end of chain. 5 dash end of chain, and this is 3 dash end of chain. 5 dash end of chain opposite, we will going to get a 3 dash end of chain, and for 3 dash end opposite, we are going to get a 5 dash end of chain. And coming to the point, two nucleic acid chains wound about each other. Two nucleic acid chains wound about each other and held together by hydrogen bonds between the pairs of bases. So this is a one polynucleotide chain. And this is another polynucleotide chain. Nothing but nucleic acid chains. Nucleic acid chain, nothing but polynucleotide chains. These polynucleotide chains has a bases. They has bases, nitrogen containing heterocyclic compound, nothing but bases. So between the bases there is a hydrogen bond formation. As a result, these two chains are held together by hydrogen bonds between the pairs of bases. So two chains are held together because of the presence of hydrogen bonds between the two strands, between the pairs of two strands. Next, two strands are complementary to each other because hydrogen bonds are formed between specific pairs of bases. If you look at the structure, here guanine form the hydrogen bond with cytosine, and here adenine form the hydrogen bonds with thymine. So two strands are complementary to each other because hydrogen bonds are formed between specific pairs of bases. In this case, adenine forms hydrogen bond. Adenine form hydrogen bonds with thymine. Adenine form hydrogen bond with thymine. And another one is guanine or cytosine form hydrogen bond with guanine. Cytosine form hydrogen bonds with guanine. So here adenine forms the hydrogen bond with thymine, and cytosine forms the hydrogen bond with guanine. And two strands are complementary to each other because hydrogen bonds are formed between the specific pairs of bases. So I already said between the guanine and cytosine there is a formation of hydrogen bond. Between the thymine and adenine there is a formation of hydrogen bonds. So this is the briefly structure of DNA. This is nothing but a double stranded helix structure for DNA.